Presented by Coors Light.
Pittsburgh Penguins versus Washington Capitals.
They got two in the first. Crosby with an assist. Malkin with an assist on the two. Then Crosby scored late in the second. And Malkin with an assist on Neal's goal in the third.
And Doc, the Dobermans are on for you for both teams.
If they're doing what they usually do, I will let you hear the boards in black. There's one. And an angry word was spoken, I think.
It was all right.
It was a good one, I think. I don't think it was bad. Well, let's see. That was just Fleury crashing the boards. Chopped on further. Now that I've said that, a couple of fans are banking the glass in anger. Okay, so forget that. Meanwhile, moving in is Glass. Good hit on him by Alexi. Just a crossbody, just carrying him off. Meanwhile, this is brought back on and trying to gain the zone. And then forearm shivered for his trouble was Lotta. Crosby outlets. Ovechkin was trying to follow through on a check on him. Bennett wended one on around off Kunitz. Crosby taps to Kunitz. Gets to control. Played on to Crosby. Led back for Orpik. And Orpik dropped it back on where it can be played further by Kunitz. An effective game of keep away. That one went off of Ovechkin. And we get a stoppage of play on an offside pass.
A matchup that won't go away. Orpik and Martin against Ovechkin, Backstrom, and Johansson. And it's worked wonders tonight for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Paul Martin, a very well-spoken young man from Elk River, Minnesota. He made the Gophers team at Minnesota out of high school. The only freshman coming directly from high school and not the USHL was Paul Martin in that year.
Doc, there weren't a lot of guys in the Jersey Devils used to draft that never went to the American Hockey League. Even Marty Brodeur and Zach Parise did. Paul Martin never did. Scott Gomez never did. Scott Niedermeyer never did. But outside of that, it's a short list that didn't go to Lou Yu down in the American Hockey League.
I never heard it called that. Lou Lamoriello, the longtime president and general manager of the New Jersey Devils, who came on in 86-87. Bounced along now for Ward, and in on goal on Fleury. All time now. These top three guys are in the Hockey Hall of Fame, and Sidney Crosby, in points per game average, is fourth in all the history of the NHL over 90 years. Gretzky at 192, Mario Lemieux at 188, Mike Bossy at 150, and Crosby at 141. 99, 66, 22, and 87. Well, you have to show some footage of Mike Bossy again. People deserve to see, if they've never seen, the way that guy could skate and shoot.
Come down the right wing and just blast it. Pretty good sentiment on his line, too, for a long time. Brian Trottier, the former Penguin.
Reverse back on into some trouble here. Mata tried to clear it. It went out. Did it glance out? Yeah, apparently so.
And Doc, the left winger who you liked a lot. He was a little bit nasty.
Jethro?
Yes.
That was the nickname of Clark Gillies.
Yes.
Rather large guy who would tend to neutralize aggressive players. And also collect some points along the way as we get another change here for the Washington Capitals. The only teams to have ever finished first in power play and in penalty killing were both teams of the New York Islanders. No one has ever been number one in both in a season. Played back on now for the carry back by Brooks Light. Handed back over to Erat. Erat protects, fires it around behind. Capitals began the night number two in both categories. It has not served them that well in this game. But that is excellence that they could not bring tonight that they have in a lot of the other games this year. Up the wing it comes for Letang, and Letang shot turned aside by Holtby, sent to the corner by Carlson, who tumbled down to the ice. Meanwhile, it's held along the boards by a stickless player named Brower, and it can be played the other way with 3:05 left on the night. Punched back in by Lotta. Handed along for a centering pass, and a good recoil was made there. James Neal got it on a cross. Gibbons tried to return. Bounced off a cap over to Neal, who regathers the forces at center. Gibbons sent it back in, slugged along by Alexi. Minnesota is tied with Chicago for first in the Central Division. The Wild has won again. They won in Ottawa tonight, and so there are eight teams in the NHL with 30 points, all of them in the West, and Minnesota has 32, tied for first overall in the league with Anaheim and Chicago. Mike,
that's a heck of a bounce back for the Wild, who were not very good last night, probably played their worst game of the season in Montreal. Max Pacioretty with a natural hat trick, Josh Hardy getting pulled, but that's a great bounce back against a very urgent Ottawa Senators team.
Brought back ahead by Volpatti, brought up to his own pass, blocked over a bit by Engelin. Puck kicked out in front, and is carried back up by Adams. Backhands it on, hoping for Tanner Glass. Got it to him. Backhander was off the outside of the cage. England across, drive by Niskanen is turned aside as the Penguins may have gotten shot 40 through. The board shows 39 right now.
And Doc, they haven't stopped at all. They're relentless going to the net in front of Braden Holtby.
England there, connected back up to Adams. Backhanded it on in, and it's Schmidt after. It is indeed 40 shots for the Penguins tonight. 17 in the first, 15 in the second. And with a lot of the heat off and just trying to be containing defensive-minded Penguins here in the third, they have only had 8. But the Caps have had only 3 in this third period. Crosby fed, but it is cut off, and Backstrom had it back-checked away. And Kunitz threw it around behind. Did a magnificent job. There are nights like that. The bug in the windshield. The windshield tonight wears white. Final 55 of the night. Don't forget the postgame, and Pierre will be on that. We understand he'll be talking to Paul Martin, the guy that just made that defensive play to free it up for his team again. Sent back across in the last 35. Hrabowski led it ahead. Some nights there is just unbridled excellence, and that's what the Penguins have had. Caps have had that on other nights, but not this game. Not tonight. Fleury again to stop it. UPMC would like this one. It was surgical. A stop by Fleury. A shutout for Fleury. Two more points for the Penguins, and they strengthen their lead in the Metropolitan Division.
This is the worst game ever for the Washington Capitals. The worst! Man, this team really sucks. There is no way that they're going to win against other hockey teams. No freaking way!
We'll have an interview with Paul Martin. But first, let's check in with Liam McHugh in our NBCSN studio.
Doc, thanks so much. Ahead, we leave D.C., but we're talking about the Senators. An early candidate for assist of the year leads to an amazing shorthanded goal for Ottawa. We will break down a Wild one. Plus, much more for the Verizon Center, where Ovechkin and the Caps are still talking about the clinic Crosby and the Pens put on down in D.C. NHL Overtime presented by Bud Light is next.